You have such a beautiful lake.
Yeah. A beautiful what? Lake.
A lake. Your lake is so beautiful.
Lake? Interesting. Okay.
Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Luba.
And my name is Stryker. Our channel is about dating in Ukraine.
And taking a practical approach to that. Please subscribe to our channel. Visit our website, www.hardturkey.com. Talk to us. We're doing a call. So if you're planning your trip to Ukraine or you don't know what to do with your current relationship, we are there for you. And please subscribe to our Telegram channel. The link is in the description below. Today's video, I wanted to do for a long time. Stryker was kind of like, nah, I'm not sure. Like, is it the strong topic? Like, is it interesting? He still thinks the same, but I convinced him. I don't ask how, need to use some female magic. And actually, I think it's important. Like, I also like it.
Thank you so much. I think there is merit to this. It's about the five love languages, you know. And Luba was telling me to read this book for a while, and I was not. But she read books that I suggest. So I had to repay this favor. So I also read this book. I do think it has got merit. I do think if you want to understand the woman that you are with, you need to understand kind of like what she is wanting. Now,
it doesn't... So if the guys don't know what we're talking about, there is a very famous book. Like, I think it was famous 10 years ago and 5 years ago and even now. It's called Five Love Languages by Gary Chapman. So if you haven't heard about that, just Google it. We will cover what is exactly it's talk about, like, very shortly. So go ahead.
Most of you guys probably know what it is. If not, just go and have a look at it. But it's basically, there's five ways that she will feel appreciated, I suppose, isn't it? That's her.
What do you mean her? It's just both of them.
Yeah, okay.
So basically, five love languages.
Don't worry about us. We don't care about it. We're just going to make sure the woman is happy.
Right? No, but woman wants to make sure that the man is happy.
Oh, now this is interesting. Anyway.
So five love languages. The reason of this video is actually because you created two other languages. That's the only reason he agrees for this video, is because when we talk about that, so five love languages. First, it's words of affirmation. Second is physical touch. Third is receiving gifts. Fourth, it's a quality time. And fifth, it's an act of service. So we will not go in depth about that, but I would like you guys, online there's a test. If you don't know, like, I would like you to put what is your number one, maybe if you can't decide, like, number one and number two love language exactly for you. Please share about that in the comments below. I'm very curious about that, because I will share my opinion about that, like, what I think important for the guys, and we'll share with you the guys what is important for the women. But please just decide for yourself what is the most important for you in the relationship. Online they also create, like, a test. So you can answer several questions and it will help you to understand, but I think that you can do it yourself. So I will say it again, it's words of affirmation, physical touch, receiving gifts, quality time, and acts of service. So after reading this book, my dear Stryker, he said, you know, bullshit, I have another idea, I have better idea. This, I don't really care about this love language, I need two more. So what are them?
I'm not sure, but I know one of them was peace and quiet.
No, it's two. Like, it's actually peace and quiet.
Oh, okay. So maybe it's two. But yeah, peace and quiet was a good one. You know, so that's my one.
You know, and I like it so much. It's like a lot of guys go into a lot of stress, and women as well. And they don't understand that you can do whatever, like, to the relationship. But if you don't feel this peace and quiet, if you don't feel comfortable with your partner, if you can't relax and you're always stressed and you always try to, like, sometimes guys do that. They try to convince the lady in something, or they're trying to prove something or show something. Then it's not a healthy relationship. What do you think?
Yeah, I think the actual... the categories or the love languages, they're reasonable. Now, I think if a woman was saying, the way that I feel loved is when you buy me gifts, I think that this can be a little bit of a problem, right? Because it's just such a materialistic thing. And if the way to make her feel loved is by buying her stuff, then that means it's very easy for her to fall in love with a guy, right?
And you know, unfortunately, this will be like in top three for the ladies, usually, receiving gifts. unfortunately.
Yeah, yeah.
It's usually not first. So
I'm not saying there's anything necessarily wrong with it.
But I understand what you mean. If she says
that that's the way to my heart is to buy me stuff.
This is not right.
It's a red
But flag. What is like? What do you think? According to this, like, okay, one sentence, first for striker, first and second is peace and quiet. You can put it as a one or as a two. What else is important?
Well, that's kind of a joke, but I guess most guys are going to...
It's not a joke. It's pretty serious.
Well, yeah, it's deadly serious. But I think
it's my phone.
Yeah, yeah, I know. I'm just checking here what they are again. So I think for most guys, it's going to be physical touch. I mean, I don't think you can have a romantic, intimate, sexual relationship without physical touch. It is important. I think it's the most important part of a man-to-woman relationship, you know? The other stuff here, like words of affirmation and quality time.
Usually for the guys, words of affirmation and physical touch are top two. I'm curious again, like, please guys, share your opinion about that. Receiving gifts is usually number five for the guys. Active service usually number four, and quality time it's like in top three somewhere. But for the ladies, unfortunately, it's a bit different. So, like, if I talk about myself, for example, for me,
did you say active service for the guy, it's down low? I disagree with that. I think active service is usually quite high, because that's how she can show that she's, you know.
But for the guys, you know, I would say that for them it's enough. Words of affirmation, it's enough for the guys.
No.
Uh-huh, when the girl is saying, like, you're my superhero, like, you're the best man I ever met.
Well, yes, but women, like you never judge a woman by what she says, but on how she acts.
No,
right?
She treats you shitty, of course, and she say that, then it's like,
that's
it's
why,
perfect,
that's
but
why,
it's like
that's
mixture
why I think
of that.
The acts of service, because every man wants a woman who's like kind and caring, has these qualities that would be good for as a mother and a wife. And I think that the acts of service, like, she can really win him over. And we've seen this stuff before.
For the woman, like, for me, for example, like, for me, important, like, a quality time and act of service, you know, this is like, what word of affirmation.
What about the gifts?
That will be number three or four.
Three and four and five.
But definitely not number one and number two.
Okay,
but for example, words of affirmation, I know that for the ladies, it usually doesn't work. That's why we did these videos, like, don't say, like, I wish I would be there for you. I hope I can make your day better. For her, like, she needs her man to act. Like, the words doesn't really matter for her. And, like, when you say, like, I love you, you know, for her, like, if the ladies say, I love you, for the guys, usually, like, wow, she said that to me, like, it's so special. And I know maybe you're skeptical about that, but...
why would it be skeptical?
I know that for a lot of guys, like, it's pretty important words to hear. When for the lady, it is important as well, but she need to see that along with the action. And it shouldn't be, it's not about just gifts, it's about, like, as we say, you know, like, if she's coughing, give her a glass of water. If she's cold, like, put the blanket...
Or a COVID test.
Yes, COVID test. Ha, ha, ha.
But anyway, I mean, I guess it is important to understand these, I think, right? You know, there's a whole bunch of other things on the other side, which is like, you know, frame, being competent as a man in the masculine role, which is what she's going to look at. There's all these things as well, but I do think that this here is important to kind of understand, and then understand what it is that she, you know, how she is going to feel appreciated and well in this relationship, because there is that part of it as well. There is understanding.
It's very important.
That, you know?
It is important. If you know what she likes and you will do that for her, and she knows what you like. This is actually like this guy, he's a psychologist, I believe. I read it a long time ago, but I think that he was going like, not through divorce, I think that they didn't divorce, but he started thinking like why their relationship didn't work out, and like maybe there's something that they're missing in their relationship. And when he understand that, you know, his love languages is this, this and that, and her love languages is that, that and that, because usually what's happening is that, for example, the guy physical touch, and the guy like words of affirmation, and he will do that to the lady all the time because it's his love languages. That is the key. And maybe for her, she like it as well, but for her, first of all, go and fix your shower.
So the thing that I actually do like about this, you know, because if you look at the other side, like, I guess if you went down the red pill route to try and understand female nature, it's very binary. You know, it's like it has to be this, 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 and this. But the thing that I believe that lacks is the variables that can happen with a woman, right? Women are different. So you can't say that all women are like this, and this is how you must be if you want to have a woman, you know, with you. I think that if you take that, but also integrate, you know, the variables of what she wants, what she appreciates, things that are important to her, and combine them together, I think then you're more likely to have a relationship where she is happy. Because, let's face it, like if she's not happy in the relationship, it's not going to work, right? And it's not going to work for you because you're not going to have sex. She's not going to be nice to hang out with. You know, there's a whole bunch of other stuff there that if she's happy, then of course it comes back onto you. It's not always about, you know, she needs to be in my frame. She needs to shut up and do this and blah, 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 blah.
But remember that first of all, you need to care about peace and quiet in your relationship, and then everything will work out. Mm-hmm. If you feel it, just go for it. We hope you enjoy this video, and please share your love language in the description. I'm very curious. I will definitely read, because our guys, like our subscribers, they're like our friends. Like some of them we really know very well, and some of them we don't, but you are with us for so long that we know you. We already feel that we know you. So if you're planning a trip to Ukraine, please give us a call and we will definitely recommend you what is the best and the most efficient way exactly for you. We see you guys next time.
We'll see you next time.